This example says that in the circuit shown in figure, we are required to find the energy stored in 4 microfarad capacitor in a steady state. If we wish to find out the energy in the 4 microfarad capacitor, we need to calculate the potential difference across the capacitor, say if this terminal is A and this terminal is B. Then energy stored in this 4 microfarad capacitor can be given as half C multiplied by potential difference between AB square. Now in a steady state, obviously there won't be any current flow in this branch of the circuit, so there will be only 2 loops. And to calculate the potential difference across points A and B, let us consider the currents in the loops, like say here a current I1 flows in clockwise manner, and here we consider a current I2 flows in also in clockwise manner. If we calculate the value of current I1, we are easily able to calculate the potential difference across A and B. So in this we write first KVL equation for I1. If we write down the equation for I1, we start say from this point. Here this will be a drop in potential of 40, and then it will be minus 5I1. Then again it is minus 5I1, and then it will be minus 10 I1 minus I2 is equals to 0. And in this situation, if we further simplify this equation, here we can cancel this 5, this will be 2 and this will be 8. So in this situation, on simplifying, you can see we are getting this 4I1 minus 2I2 is equals to minus 8. Further, we can simplify this as this 2 gets cancelled out, this 4. So this 2I1 minus I2 is equals to minus 4. This is your equation 1. Now, if we write down KVL equation for I2, then for the second loop, if we write down the KVL equation, say we start from this terminal. So in this situation, it will be a drop of minus 10 I2. Then in this 10 ohm resistance, it is minus 10 I2 minus I1. Then it is gain of 20 volts, so it is plus 20. We can write it equals to 0. Now in this situation, if we further simplify, here you can see this will give us I1 minus, in this situation, if we take this on the right hand side, this will be I1 minus 2I2 is equals to minus 2. Now this is our equation number 2, and from these 2 equations we are willing to calculate the value of I1. So to eliminate I2, we just multiply it by 2, and this equation we subtract from this equation. So you can see what we are getting. This will be minus plus plus. So in this situation, 2 into 2, 4 I1 minus I1, we can write it as 3 I1. Here minus 2 I2 and plus 2 I2 gets cancelled out. This will be minus 8 plus 2 will be equals to minus 6. So here we are getting the value of I1 as minus 2 ampere. This is the current in this branch of circuit, which will help us in calculation of potential difference from A to B. So here we write the KVL equation, separately we are handling it, KVL equation from A to B. If we write, you can see what we are getting in this situation. From point A we start, this potential VA, then in this direction it will be minus 5 I1, I1 we are given with minus 2 ampere, and then it is gain of 20 volt potential, then it is equals to VB. So here you can see the value of potential difference VB minus VA. We are getting is this 20 plus 10, that will be 30 volt. And if we know the potential difference, then we can easily calculate the energy in 4 microfarad capacitor, which is half capacitance is 4 microfarad multiplied by it is 30 square. And as it is given in microfarad, it will be in microjoules. So, in this situation, the final result we are getting is 900 multiplied by 2, 1800 microjoule, or it can be written as 1.8 millijoule. That will be the answer to this problem.